outside lately? What a beautiful world we live in. Have you seen the trees and the animals and the sun and the sky and the stars at night? Have you taken some time to really appreciate the beautiful world that God created for us? Well, remember in the first book of the Bible, in Genesis, God spoke these things into existence. He is the great creator. He created all of this just by speaking. And he spoke lights and the sun and the moon and the land. And on that fourth day, God spoke and he spoke trees and bushes and flowers. And some of those, he said, were to have fruit. And he spoke, and there goes the apple. And he spoke, and he made trees and bushes and plants that created fruit and seeds inside those fruit. And that seed, when you open up an apple and you plant one of those apple seeds, guess what's going to grow? An apple tree. And that apple tree is going to make more apples. And he said that the seed will produce more of its own kind. So when we see an apple, we know where it came from. When you go to Publix or Aldi's and you see a pineapple, you know it came from a pineapple plant. When you see a watermelon, you know it came from a watermelon vine. And when you see an apple, you know it came from an apple tree. But do you know that the Bible talks about fruit in us? Not apples and bananas and grapes. But we can have fruit. We can produce fruit. We can make fruit as a person in this life that tells people who we belong to. Now that sounds a little strange, Miss Marlene. Well, give me a few minutes and I'll explain it, and hopefully you'll understand what God is talking about when we talk about the fruit of the Spirit. Paul, one of Jesus's disciples, after he left, in Galatians, he wrote the book of Galatians. It's a letter, actually. And listen to what he wrote. He wrote, "But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, long-suffering, gentleness, goodness, faith, meekness, and temperance." That doesn't sound like fruit. Well, that's what he's saying, the fruit of the Spirit. So before we understand that, think about what he just said. Love is a fruit. Joy, another fruit. Peace, long-suffering. What does that long word mean? We'll talk about it in a minute. And gentleness, and goodness, and faith, and meekness, and temperance, 9 of them. And he just called them fruit. Well, it's not the kind of fruit that we're talking about or you're thinking about. You see, sometimes in our language, fruit or words can mean something different. If I hit a ball, a baseball, that's one kind of ball. But if I dress up like a princess and go to a royal ball, that's another kind of ball. So fruit in what Paul is saying is a little different. Listen to what Jesus himself said. He told us in the book of Matthew, are you ready? He said, In Matthew, he said, "Wherefore by their fruits ye shall know them." Remember when Jesus spoke to the crowds when he was teaching people, he used things all around that people would understand. So in those times, people would understand when you plant something and it grows and it bears a fruit. They would understand sheep and goats. And sometimes he talked about the mustard seed. So he talked in ways to try to help people understand who he was, to try to understand God's kingdom. So in this one, listen to what Jesus said, "Wherefore by their fruits ye shall know them." He's not talking apples and bananas. He's talking that for us as his people, as a Christ follower, if we're calling ourselves a Christian, if we're saying that we are a follower of Jesus Christ, the Son of God, people will know us by our fruits. And Paul just said those fruits of the Spirit are love, joy, peace, long-suffering, gentleness, goodness, faith, meekness, and temperance. So listen to what else Jesus said to help us try to understand what is Paul talking about. And it's not apples and bananas. It is not this kind of apple. It is not this kind of peach. It is not this kind of orange. It is definitely, we are definitely not making pineapples, which would be kind of cool, but that's not what Paul's talking about. Listen to what else Jesus said. Jesus said, this is one of the I am statements. We've talked about that a few times. "I am the vine and ye are the branches," Jesus said. "He that abideth in me and I in him, the same bringeth forth," ready, "much fruit. So Jesus said, he's the vine, we are the branches, and if we abide or are stuck on or live through or are connected to Jesus, we will bear, we will bring forth much fruit. Not this kind of fruit. That's what Paul was saying. This kind of fruit. Love, joy, peace, long-suffering, gentleness, goodness, faith, meekness, temperance. But how's that going to happen, Miss Marlene? How are we going to bear or bring fruit to these things that Paul's talking about? Well, if we go a little bit higher than the verse that we read, that was verse 22 in Galatians 5, listen to what Paul said right before. Walk in the Spirit. Now, my Bible has a big capital S, which is not just an ooh, like a spirit we talk about sometimes. Because you see, God's word teaches us that God is actually three people, persons in one. Now, that's a little hard sometimes to understand and capture. And some things we just need to ask the Lord to give us wisdom to help us understand. So God the Father, God the Son, which is Jesus Christ, and God the Holy Spirit. Jesus said when he was done here, when he died on the cross for us and he rose again that third day, he said, it is good that I go back to heaven because I'm going to send you the Comforter, the Holy Spirit. So this is the great news. When we accept Jesus as our Lord and Savior, when we accept forgiveness, when we ask him to forgive us, when we ask him to redeem us, to buy us back by what he did on the cross, when we believe in the power of the cross and his blood, guess what? We become a child of God, and he sends the Holy Spirit to live in our hearts. So when Paul said, but the fruit of the Spirit, capital S, that's the Holy Spirit in us. I know sometimes the mysteries of God's word, that's why we need to read, we need to meditate, we need to think about, we need to go to Sunday school so our teachers can explain, we need to listen to pastor, just so the Holy Spirit, the same Holy Spirit we're talking about, can help us understand. He's our comforter, but he's also our teacher, he's our guide, he teaches us, he fills us with this knowledge. When we don't understand, he opens our mind. So, in walking with the Spirit, that's what Paul said, walk in the Spirit. And he also said a little further down, led of the Spirit. We need to allow God's Holy Spirit to guide us, to help us understand. So let's go over this fruit. It's not a pineapple. Love is not a pineapple. The love of God. When we walk with God's Spirit, when we're his child and we're learning and growing every day and seeking the Lord and seeking his presence and praying and reading his word, that love of God, that love that compelled him to leave his throne and come die for us on a cross, we can have that in our life. We can show that to others. We can love others. It's easy to love those that love us back. But Jesus even said we could love our enemies. Only with the Holy Spirit. That's the love that we can bear fruit, we can show. And how about joy? Joy is like happiness, but it's not like happiness. You see, happiness for me is a plate of sushi. And when that sushi is gone, that happiness just faded away. I ate it all up. Joy is different. God's word says that the joy of the Lord is my strength. What does that mean? Joy means that I can have that satisfaction, that peace, that happiness, that just trust that God loves me, that I am his child, that no matter what, he is with me, he is preparing a place for me. That joy in my heart, no matter what the circumstance, is my strength in anything that goes on in my life. Just like peace. Peace, not like two armies not fighting and that kind of peace that sometimes we see on TV or the peace signs. That's not what God is talking about. That's not the fruit of our spirit when we walk with God's Spirit. This peace is a peace that surpasses all understanding. We read about martyrs sometimes or missionaries in crazy situations, in dangerous situations, but they have God's peace inside. Because at the end of the day, we're just here for a little bit. We have our heavenly home waiting for us. We have Jesus waiting for us. He died on the cross. There's nothing that can happen on this earth that he's not in control of. That's the peace. No matter what's going on, I know who God is, and I know he's in control, and he loves me. Love, joy, peace. Now the big word, long-suffering. What does that mean? That's a really long, fancy word for patience. Are we walking in patience? Do people know us from our patience? When your little brother takes your toy, do you have patience? Are you showing love, joy, and peace and patience toward your little brother? Or maybe towards your parents? Or maybe towards a grandmother or an elderly person? That patience? Also, patience is waiting for God's will and God's timing. It's not going to always be how we want it or when we want it. God's timing is perfect, and we need to have patience, long-suffering, trusting that Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit gives us that patience. Just trust that God is in control and in His timing and in His will and purpose for us. We need to wait and rest on that. Gentleness, also kindness. We can say kindness for gentleness. Are we kind to others? When people talk to us, when we go to somebody else's house, at school, with our family, do they know us by our kindness? Are we kind to everybody, not just those that are kind to us? Are we kind to the grumpy old neighbor sometimes? Yeah, Holy Spirit, we can have that. Not by our own strength. Love, joy, peace, long-suffering, gentleness. Remember, that's patience and kindness and goodness. Goodness means a lot of things. Are we seeking good things? Be careful, little eyes. Be careful, little ears. What are we saying? What are we seeking? Are we producing good things for the Lord? How we work, what we say, what we do, what we watch, what we read. Are we seeking good things? Is goodness coming out of us? And then we have faith. Faith is also faithfulness. In whatsoever ye do, do it heartily as unto the Lord. Our chores, do we do it with faithfulness? Are we a faithful student when the teacher says to do 1 through 10? Do we do 1 through 10, not just the even? Do we skip over it? Are we honest? Do people know by the way that we work, by the way that we present ourselves, by our faithfulness, that we belong to God? Is that fruit in our life? And then we have meekness. Now, meekness is not weakness. Some people like to think, oh, meekness is weak. No, it's not. Meekness simply means humble, teachable heart. Just like the disciples, just like they were always ready to hear what Jesus had to teach. We know who's in control. We know that God is above all things, that He is Almighty God. We are not in control. He is. Are we walking with that humble, teachable heart? Not thinking pridefully that we know everything. I got this. Oh, I know. Are we ready to learn? Are we ready to hear what the Spirit has for us? When we open God's word, are we have a heart with meekness, ready to see what God has for us? And then finally, temperance. Another fancy word for self-control. That's a big one, especially as you're growing up. When you're younger, self-control is something that is hard to do. But God's word says that with His Holy Spirit, He can jumpstart us. He gives us the ability to be control in our emotions, control in our behavior, maybe in our family, or maybe in a little spat with a sibling, maybe at school and with a kid at recess. So many situations where we need to have self-control, where maybe even our flesh, our sinful nature wants to do these ugly things, but the self-control to say, that's not what God wants me to do. I'm going to do the right thing. Wow. Could you imagine with the Holy Spirit, walking by the Spirit, led by the Spirit, we can walk in love, joy, peace, long-suffering, gentleness, goodness, faith, meekness, and temperance. But here's the thing. We can't have the Holy Spirit inside of us. We can't walk in the Spirit. We can't produce this fruit by ourselves. Remember what Jesus said, I am the vine and you are the branches, and without me, you can do nothing. Now, we can do a few things. Our sinful nature, which we're born with, can do a lot of things on its own. We can hate. We can envy. We can have jealousy. We can fight. We can argue. There could be strife. We could be disobedient. We could do that all by ourselves. But is that who Jesus wants us to be? Is that who God sent Jesus to die on the cross for us to show that? Will people see us and know who we belong to by our fruit? Just like when you see a watermelon, you know it came from a watermelon vine. In order for people to know that we belong to Jesus Christ, that we are a follower of the Son of God, this is the fruit that we need to show. And how do we walk in this fruit? How do we do this? Again, without the Holy Spirit, walking by the Spirit, led by the Spirit. That's how we produce this fruit, where people around us, the whole world, can see, what is it about that person? What is it? How do they love? How do they have joy in this circumstance? How do they have that self-control when I just said something ugly? That shows that we belong to Jesus Christ, and it's by His Spirit only. wow, that's the kind of person I want to be for Jesus. I want everywhere that I go, everything that I say, everything that I do, that people would know beyond a shadow of a doubt that I belong to Jesus Christ. And that's my challenge to you. Do you know him as your Lord and Savior? That's the first part. If you don't, talk to mom or dad. When Sunday school starts, talk to your Sunday school teacher. Call us here at church. That's the most important. Because when you become a child of God, that's when you get his Holy Spirit inside. And with the Holy Spirit, and you ask the Holy Spirit, Lord, help me to understand God's word. Read his word, draw closer to the Lord, abide in Jesus. That means stay so close you can't be separated from Jesus. And that is how we produce the fruit, bear much fruit for our Lord. Wow. I'm excited. I'm excited for you. I'm excited for you to think about this, meditate upon this, read it again in Galatians. Ask the Lord to show you so you can show that fruit. You can show that fruit for Jesus. Wow. We love you. God bless you. See you next time.